All right, Gwenn, we're headed off again. Where are we headed now? We're headed over to a small glacier here that's currently surging. We just found this in July as we were doing a reconnaissance of the Kluane Glacier. We noticed this chaotic ice coming down a valley. We went to explore. We found this glacier was in full surge.
So, surging, what does that mean?
Surging is episodic fast flow of a glacier, and what that means is that a glacier will go really fast, 10 to 1,000 times its normal speed for 1 or 2 years, and then it'll slow way down for decades. So it's almost like a yo-yo. It goes fast and slow, fast and slow.
And why are you studying surging glaciers? What do they tell us about climate, for example?
Well, surging's so interesting because we think of it as being independent of climate. It's an internal property or dynamic of the glacier itself. But what we're finding in this mountain range in the St. Elias is that some of the smaller glaciers that used to surge aren't surging anymore. Surging requires a certain climate envelope. Glaciers need enough mass or oomph to be able to surge. And some of these small glaciers have just been starved of mass over the last decades to the point that they're not surging any longer.
So the one you're looking at, what will you be able to measure around its surge?
We'll be able to look at its velocity, so how fast it's flowing at the surface. We'll be able to look at how far it's advanced, how much mass has been transferred downstream, so how much downdrop there's been at high elevations, and how much inflation at low elevations. And that tells us something about how the process of surging works.
So you're going to set up a camera down there.
Well, we're setting up a time-lapse camera at the edge of this surging glacier to see what happens to it over the winter. So typically, surges in this area last from 1 to 2 years in the very dramatic phase. This glacier started surging last winter and really had a pulse of speed in the late spring. And we're interested in seeing if the surge is finished or if it goes on for another year.
Now, we've observed that studying glaciers is hard physical work. And it's pretty lonely out here. There's a large amount of space and not too many scientists. Do we know what we need to know about the largest non-polar ice in the world?
I don't think we do. I think there's so much more to learn. This is just a geophysical playground here. We've got all sorts of interesting glacier dynamics to study. And meanwhile, we've got glacier mass balance changes, so negative balances that are causing a lot of mass loss.
So the one we're going to see, the surging one, How is its mass? Has it got enough oomph to continue?
Well, that's what's interesting. This glacier is kind of a mid-sized glacier, and this surge is spectacular. So clearly it did have enough oomph to execute this surge. Glaciers that are slightly smaller have shut down their surge cycle. So that's why I was so interested to see this slightly larger glaciers still have the ability to surge. You know, less than a few percent of the world's glaciers surge, so this is a pretty special dynamic. And this area of the world is one of those areas especially known for its high concentration of surge-type glaciers. High mountain Asia, Svalbard, Iceland, Alaska, and Yukon are some of the places that are known for their abundance of surge-type glaciers. And they really offer us a great opportunity to understand glacier dynamics, because they're the fastest form of glacier flow that we have in these mountains.
Do you like it?
Oh, I like it a lot.
So great.
Really
cool. Oh, like it's even... just as good as July, even better. Like, did you see those sheared up tributaries?
Oh yeah.
I mean, it's just like, oh, it's just amazing! And I just love how all these tributaries are sheared up and you can see the downdrop, like the stranded ice along the valley floors, and then you get down there and you see the shear margins and the ice that's raised way above the valley walls. It's just such, it's an amazing spectacle. You really get a sense of how the mass is transferred from up there down low. It's just amazing.